Good morning, Redhawks. Today is Monday, November 12th. I'm Kirsten Mitlock.
And I'm Sarah Comte.
And welcome to Today at the Creek.
Please stand for the pledge, followed by the moment of silence.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Good morning, Redhawks. I'm Ayn Von Lowe. Today in history, let's see what happened on November 12th. In 1799, the first meteor shower on record hits. In 1965, Goldenrod sets the land speed record. In 1980, Voyager 1 flies near Saturn. Today is also National French Dip Day, and happy late birthday to Christina Staggs. Now back with Kirsten Sarah with today's announcements.
Congratulations to the SEHS swim team for placing 3rd out of 16th over the weekend in Lebanon. Come out to Oakland this Saturday as they take on Blackman and Siegel.
Governor's school applications are due to your counselor no later than November 16th.
If you're interested in purchasing holiday plans, find an ACT student or teacher to place your order. These are due by Friday, November 16th.
Now to weather with Action Jackson.
Hey, Redhawks. Action Jackson here with the weather on the creek. Today, there will be a high of 47 and a low of 36. After school, it will be 46, and there will be rain throughout the day. Tomorrow, there will be a high of 41 and a low of 30. It will be cloudy. Now back to Kirsten and Sarah.
The Redhawks and Lady Redhawks basketball season kicks off tomorrow night in the annual Hall of Fame game. Girls play at 6 and guys play at 7:30.
Congratulations to the Redhawks soccer coach Brooke Mayo, who received the AF Bridges Female Coach of the Year from the TSSAA for District 4.
Stewart's Creek is hosting its third annual Thanksgiving Week here at the Creek from November 12th through the 16th. ICU classes will be collecting canned goods for our local Smyrna Food Bank.
On Friday the 16th, we will count the cans, and the class with the highest giving percentage will receive a pizza party.
Now for the Stewart's Creek Sports Report with Maddox and Kevin.
Good morning, Redhawks. I'm Maddox.
And I'm Kevin.
And welcome to your Stewart's Creek Sports Report.
SCTV's own Zach Lamb was quite disappointed as his Kentucky Wildcats got demolished by the Tennessee Vols over the weekend. The Vols will take on the Missouri Tigers next Saturday as they look to win two conference games in a row.
The Vanderbilt Commodores played the Missouri Tigers this past Saturday and came up short. The Commodores will take on the Ole Miss Rebels next as they look to become bowl eligible.
The MTSU Blue Raiders played the UTEP Miners over the weekend and won. They will face the Kentucky Wildcats next this Saturday.
The Vols basketball team took on the Louisiana Lafayette Raging Cajuns on the court last weekend and won. They look to extend their winning streak to 3 as they take on the Georgia Tech Yellow Jackets next tomorrow at 8.
Vanderbilt's basketball team took on the ULC Trojans and won. The Commodores will take on the Alcorn State Braves next this Friday.
MTSU's basketball team played the Milligan Buffaloes last Friday and won. The Blue Raiders will take on Belmont Bruins tonight. Tip-off is at 7.
The Memphis Grizzlies played the Philadelphia 76ers last Saturday and took home the win. The Grizzlies take on the Utah Jazz tonight. Tip-off is at 7.
The Nashville Predators defeated the Dallas Stars on the ice this past Saturday. The Preds will face the Anaheim Ducks tonight. Puck drops at 9.
Kyle Busch won yesterday in the Monster Energy Cup at Phoenix with 54 points, securing his place to compete for the 2018 Monster Energy Cup Series Championship alongside Joey Logano, Martin Truex Jr., and Kevin Harvick.
Dez Bryant practiced a total of 2 times before tearing his Achilles and ending his season. But you know, got to keep those X's up.
Over the weekend, Jimmy Butler finally got out of Minnesota as he traded to the Philadelphia 76ers. It's only a matter of time until he gets mad at his guards for not being able to shoot wide open threes.
The Tennessee Titans made easy work of the quote-unquote go in his New England Patriots for their second win in a row. They look to keep the hot streak going as they take on the Indianapolis Colts this Sunday.
Now back to Kirsten and Sarah.
Our 6th annual Hosta Holiday Marketplace will be held on November 17th from 8 a.m. to 4 p.m. If you're interested in having a booth of your own, we are still accepting vendor requests.
Track trials have been changed to Saturday, November 17th. Stay tuned for more information.
Check us out on Twitter and YouTube at Stewart's Creek Video.
That's all for today at the Creek. Have a great day, and remember, we are
one team.